please join me on a short trip to the near future. In our first scene, a preteen needs orthodontic work. But she and her parents don't just go to the nearest orthodontist or one a friend or relative recommends. Instead, they post an online request for proposals that can only be seen by nearby registered orthodontists and receive several such proposals, each of which states the qualifications of the orthodontist and a recommended treatment plan. After speaking to a couple of the orthodontists by phone, they select one to meet with in person. Once they've reviewed the treatment plan and payment schedule with the orthodontist, they authorize it electronically via digital signatures on their flexible smartphones. The family's health care insurance makes progress payments directly deposited into the orthodontist's account immediately upon completion of each visit. The family makes their co-payments using airline frequent flyer miles, and at no point is any paperwork required in the entire process. All of these phenomenal innovations possible. Well, certainly a number of technologies come into play. 3D printing, virtual reality, biometrics. But there is one technology that runs through all of these examples. It's called blockchain technology. And no less prestigious a publication than The Economist magazine has stated that blockchain is quite simply the most important advance in record keeping since the invention of the double entry bookkeeping system in Florence, Italy in 1494, over 500 years ago. Blockchain technologies do four key things that we've not been able to do nearly so well and together previously. First, they provide a permanent, immutable, signed and time-stamped record of identity, ownership, transactions, or commitments. Secondly, that record can then be shared among two or more entities, people, businesses, other organizations, what have you, without any one of the entities in that ecosystem having to depend on any one of the others or having to pay a third-party intermediary to facilitate the sharing of that information. Third, the information can be made globally available to all of the authorized participants with complete transparency for everyone authorized to see it and the authority to update that information for that subset of those who are authorized to do so. At the same time, it provides unhackable security against those unauthorized to update that information or even see it. Well, when people realized what this meant and that this could be used for digital currencies, they began to also realize it could be used for a lot of other things, such as electronic medical records, 3D printing design files, or real estate land titles. One more key thing that can be put on the blockchain are smart contracts. Now, this is more than just a digital version of a traditional contract created on a word processing system. Smart contracts are dynamic contracts that can be self-enforcing. It's a computer program running on a blockchain that can take custody over assets on that blockchain, track what has happened to date, and respond to incoming information or events, such as the airline has completed the execution of a smart contract and is therefore authorized to download the design file for a part. Or the orthodontist visit has been successfully completed and therefore the orthodontist is to be transferred the appropriate payment for the services rendered at that particular time without any human intervention being required in the process. But again, these are just a few of the industries. Here is a very partial list of a couple of dozen industries that will be very significantly impacted by blockchain. And if your industry is not on this list, it's only because I ran out of space, not because it's not going to be impacted by blockchain. And many of these industries already have industry consortia in place, actively developing strategic plans for using blockchain to reshape how these industries work. These consortia have come up with hundreds of use cases, just a tiny fraction of which are shown on this slide.